At this moment, the Android apps on Chrome devices is a reality. You can enable this option only if you have a Google App for Work account, or as Google call it now, a G Suite Business account. The EDU and nonprofit accounts are not yet available to use this function. Also, keep in mind that the Android apps will work only if you have any of these Chrome devices: Chromebook R11 or Chromebook C738T, Chromebook Flip, Chromebook Pixel 2015. In the future, more devices will be added to the list, and also at some point, the EDU and nonprofit accounts will have the option to enable the Play Store for their Chrome devices. When this happens, the steps I will show you now will remain the same, and you can prepare yourself with this video. Enable Android apps on Chrome OS for your domain. Android apps on Chrome OS use the Android and Google Play for Work management framework. If you enable Android apps and the domain already have an Android management subscription that uses a third-party enterprise mobility manager, EMM, such as VMware, AirWatch, or Mobile Iron, then the existing subscription and EMM combination is used. But other aspects of managing Android apps on Chrome OS are managed through the G Suite admin console. If you enable Android apps and the domain doesn't have an Android management subscription, one is created automatically and Google Device Manager is selected as the EMM. Sign in to your G Suite admin console. Click Device Management. On the left, click Chrome Management. Click Google Play Store Settings. Select Enable Android Apps to manage through the admin console. You must be a domain administrator to enable this option, and you need to accept the term of services for the Android management service. To confirm that the Android management subscription is enabled, you can go to Security, Android Management Settings, and verify that Google Device Manager EMM is listed on the security page. Enabling Android apps on Chrome OS for your domain does not automatically enable it for individual users. To give users access to the apps, you must also enable the apps for organizational units. Enable Android apps for users on an OU. Once on your G Suite admin console, click Device Management. On the left, click Chrome Management. Click User Settings. On the left, select the organization to which you want to apply the settings. Go to the Google Play App section. Select Allow for the Play Store on Chrome Devices settings. At the bottom, click Save. Settings typically take effect in minutes, but they may take up to an hour to apply for everyone. If user's device does not support Android apps, the settings has no effect. Approve apps in Google Play for Work. Sign in to the Google Play for Work at play.google.com/work using a Google Play for Work administrator account. Search for and click the app you'd like to approve. In this case, I will click on Evernote. Click Approve. To accept the app permissions on behalf of your company, click Approve. Click Done. To view a list of approved apps for your company, click My Company Apps from the Apps menu. Decide how apps are installed. There are two options. 1. Force installation of approved apps. From the list of apps you approve in Google Play for Work, you can choose a subset that the system automatically installs for every user in your organizational unit. When the user logs into the device, the system automatically starts to download these apps. The policy is independent of any other Android phone or tablet policy you have in place with a third-party EMM. That means that you can have one set of apps configured to force install on your Android phones or tablets using a third-party EMM, and a different set of apps configured to force install on Chromebooks using the admin console. Once on your G Suite admin console, click Apps, click Additional Google Services, click Chrome Management, or you can go to Device Management, Chrome Management, click App Management. On the left, select Android apps from the App Type Filter menu. Click the app you want to configure. Click User Settings. On the left, select the OU where you want to apply the setting. Turn on Force Installation and turn on Pin to Taskbar. Click Save. While the apps are being downloaded, the user can see a stop button. If they press it, the download is stopped. Another attempt at installation is made at the next login, and install attempts will continue until the apps are successfully installed, or until the apps is no longer part of the list of apps that are force installed. Number 2. Allow the installation of approved apps. If you don't want to force the installation of apps, you can create a list of apps that your users can voluntarily choose to install. The apps must be selected from the apps that you have approved in the Google Play for Work. If your company is using a third-party EMM, not Google Device Manager, to manage Android phones or tablets, this option is not available for you. If the EMM has not joined Google Play for Work, the user sees an empty Google Play for Work store on their Chromebook, and the only way for them to get an Android app is to configure the force installation of approved apps. On this same page, you have the option to allow the apps you want. When completed, just click on Save. Apps configured to allow installation appears in the Store Home section of the Google Play for Work store on the user's devices. If you follow the above steps, but your user reports an empty Google Play for Work store, it could be because you are using an EMM that is bound to a Google Play for Work but has not whitelisted any app. Google is planning to add more devices that will be able to install Android apps on the upcoming release of Chrome OS. For more information about this, you can visit the website you see on your screen now, and the link for it can be found below at the description. If you like this video, please share it with your friends on your social networks. Please subscribe to my channel if you want to see more videos like this. I am Mac, and see you in my next video.